di partai aja nih.
Goats play a key role in pastoral households' food security and incomes owing to their short generation intervals, high adaptability and versatile feeding habits. The county has an estimated 882,107 goats, with an annual meat production was estimated at 1,073,087 kg of chivon worth Kenya shillings 429,234,800. Baringo meat goat is renowned due to its tenderness and unique taste attributed to feeding on high-quality browse and natural salt licks. The demand for the meat is always on the rise. Hence, the county government and other stakeholders have been working to enhance productivity and market access for the meat goat.
I have developed sellouts, I think, in almost every ward in the county. There is a new sell yard where people can come and be able to, it's like an auction mat. It's like an auction mat that we auction animals. That has been improved significantly. We have invested quite a bit in building of those sell yards so that farmers or traders can come from all over the country to come and buy the livestock at competitive prices.
Natoka Nairobi Bande ya Uruma. Na kama kilomita 300 hivi kutoka Nairobi na kuja kununua hapa Baringo mbuzi hii soko agenyaki. Hii soko mbuzi ya hapa ni si kama bande ingine. Mbuzi ni kidogo kidogo, medium mbuzi, medium sana sana. Nyama yake watu makasoma yetu nasema nyororo. Nyama yake si ngumu na nyama yake ni pia tamu. Na bei pia at least kama bande ya sehemu nyingine kidogo iko chini. Na hata sisi ikibeleka si mbaya sana. Tuna vile tunanunua tunauza soko ya Kariobangi. Si mbaya, tunapata kitu kidogo ya chai.
Capacity building and formation of the Livestock Management Committee in charge of the sale yards in partnership with the county government with stakeholders' involvement have continuously led to smooth running of the livestock markets and increased county revenue from sales collection by more than 50%.
Joint management ya nini ya LMA na ya county government kwa mambo ya staffing imetusaidia kwa sababu moja, tukikutanisha hawa staff wa county government na hawa revenue clerks wetu na hawa nini na hawa nini LMS, huwa tunakuta ya kwamba kasi inaenda vizuri, alafu staff food migration inakuwa kubwa. So kwa management ya kwa revenue collection ina boost, inakuja juu. So ngine ni kwamba hapo awali kitambo kwa muda kabla hii soko ijakuwa imeofensiwa the way it is now, kumekuwa na nini, kulikuwa na changamoto kadha wa kadha. Lakini baada ya highlight ilikuja ya kwamba tulikuta ya kwamba hii soko ilipokuja ilipofungwa ikafenziwa vile unaona, mambo ya kuepesha mbusi ikawa that minimal, ikateremuka na revenue ikakuja juu.
This is attributed to the co-management model for the livestock markets. The MOUs gives the committees 25%, which is used for market rehabilitation and disease control. Like Nginyang market was collecting average of between Kenya shillings 10,000 and 30,000, but currently collects between 80,000 and 100,000 per market day.
Tulikuta hawa kama anarokota pesa kidogo sana. Ilikuwa kichanga shilingi 10,000, 15,000 hivi. Basi kwa hivyo tulipo kana pamoja nao. Tukakata, tulienda tukafanya MOU. Ndio tulipewa 25%. Hiyo 25% watu ya CLMC anachukua 20. Pia kwa hiyo tu. Basi hiyo. Basi sasa tukafanya tu pamoja. Saa hii angalia kutoka revenue ya kwanza ilikuwa 10 na mpaka saa hii tunachesea 1,100. Tunachesea 1,100 na kitu kwa saa hii.
The construction of livestock loading ramps and holding pens have lowered the cost of operations at the livestock market in Nginyang, Loruk, Baruesa, Turuturu and Koloa.
Hii kitu ametusaidia sana. Zamani watu nashika mbuzi na beba mbuzi ya gari mzima watu na beba na mkono. Sasa hii napeleka tu na mguu na ingia ndani. Wametusaidia. Ingefanya hii hapa ni amekuwa moja, ingekuwa mbili tatu watu asisimame leni. Naona poleni mrefu nasimama hii gari kama 5-6 nasimama leni. Inge hii watu akancho ingesaidia sisi, ingeweka mbili tatu alafu watu aende haraka hapo mbeleni. Wale wanabeba kuweka gari vijana tunalipa sahi, kwa sababu tunaweka muranda tunapigia kwa gari atulipi serikali. Wale wanafurutia sisi, ingine wanapigia sisi tu ndo nasaidiana, tunalipa hawa kidogo. Si kama zamani karama hakuna hapo.
Revival of Kimalel market. This has led to better prices of meat goods at Kimalel auction, from an average of Kenya shillings 6,000 to Kenya shillings 12,000.
The famous Kimalel auction continues to attract many people. Of course, it had gone down over the years, but for the last 3 years, we have held successful goat auctions.
1.2 million. Pigeni makofi. Haya. Mheshimiwa Kamama, 1,500. Apatiwe mbuzi ya 1,500. Mheshimiwa Jeptumo, apatiwe mbuzi ya 1,500. Mheshimiwa Kiptui, apatiwe mbuzi ya 1,500. Mheshimiwa Mwaita, apatiwe mbuzi ya 1,500.
We are improving that, not only to be so that it's not only a goat auction, it is going to be a festival, a cultural center with a meat festival, so that it will become like a carnival where people come and enjoy themselves and have meat. But basically, the Kimalel goat auction is not about selling of goats alone. It's about communicating the quality and the value of animals that Baringo County produces.
Capacity building of groups on livestock marketing, organizations of farmers into groups, training on governance, coupled with the county government intervention, such as construction of sale yards and rehabilitation and construction of a new slaughterhouse, has resulted into increase in number of buyers and sellers of meat goat at the market, which in turn have increased prices of the goats, hence better income for meat goat farmers. Initially, average goat was fetching between Kenya shillings 1,800 and 2,500. But currently fetches between Kenya shillings 4,000 and 6,000. This is income for farmers to alleviate poverty and become food secure.
We want to really appreciate the financial partners. Among them, the KCB Bank and the KCB Foundation particularly for really coming out to support our farmers through interest-free loans. It is not enough for the farmer groups to be put together, to be trained, and for production to increase if they don't have financial support. We have partners like KVDA who have continued to support our farmers in capacity building. They have also been transferring skills on hive production, especially to our farmer artisans who've been trained to make hives for sale. And we've been able to buy hives from these farmers. So we, Baringo County farmers, are producing the hives and are selling to within the county, and the hives are really good. Other partners that would really want to appreciate include the research institutions like Calro. Calro has been very supportive to us in the sense that they come to share with us the research findings. When we have issues that would want them to research on, they too have been very supportive in uptaking what we have as a challenge, and they've been able to support us. And with that, we really want to encourage more partners to continue working with us. I'll not forget the World Animal Health, which is an international organization that has supported us to be the first county to vaccinate animals against RVF in 2015. You have helped us to achieve a greater goal in saving our animals from the deadly disease, and in extension, saving the lives of the people of Baringo. Thank you, all of you. God bless you. Thank you.